get the radios in a second. I'll set this out. Flaps are up. Verified that. Trim is in the middle. Heading indicators are 30 set. Landing lights, strobe lights are on. Trim is set. Fuel pump's on. Mixture is rich. Canopy will get it in a second. And for the departure, straight out to the south, 400. And okay. Then climb up to 1,000 outside the delta. And then you want to head to Pearland, so we'll dial up 118525 on the second radio, 1,500 feet, and then circle in for the downwind on
okay.
Willis Railway.
And the Unicom there is also on that map, but okay. it's 22-8
okay.
for the Unicom for them. We got a list there, don't we? Yeah. LBJ. Okay.
You said that is a towered airport?
It's not a tower, okay. but so they use 22.8. Same as, well, as Baytown Airport.
Okay.
Well, there it's getting about three satellites.
You want to hang on here for a little bit?
No, you could go ahead and okay. ask him. We'll just
1265 tower set and holding short Bravo.
Oh, there we go.
We're good?
Yeah.
I like to tell for November 1197 Golf coming short 17 right at Bravo, ready departure to the south.
Runway 1197 Golf, Ellington Tower, runway 17 right at Bravo intersection, wind 160 at 7, cleared for takeoff.
Cleared for takeoff, 17 right, 1197 Golf. I'm bent air, guess we'll feel it when we move in. All right, get the canopy.
Integrity, kind of warning there, I guess, something not right about it.
Good.
Okay, so if we think about a soft field takeoff, remember you want to keep the yoke
yep.
all the way back. Now, as you get rolling, you're going to release that pressure so that this sight picture stays like it is, just letting the keeping the weight off the nose, letting it get off the ground a little bit. But you don't want to pop it up where you don't see the runway.
It's been a while since I've done one of these. Actually, okay. I don't think I've done one ever.
Oh, okay. All right.
So.
All right, so just come on. Kind of keep it rolling smoothly. You don't want to use a lot of brakes, so it's like you're on a muddy grass runway or even a rocky runway or something, or a rocky field. And it really, a lot of it is just teaching a little bit of precision. So I'll kind of follow you through here with it
yep.
then.
Power.
Full power there, right rudder, stay on the center line. Then you'll see as the nose starts to come back,
gotcha.
We're just keeping the weight off of right rudder, right rudder, right rudder. Now push forward some and just let it stay there. In other words, there you go. Now kind of let it just stay in ground effect here until we get up to VY, which you're at, and then climb on up normally.
Okay.
So that's a soft field takeoff. Not much to it, but.
Yeah. The landings are
kind of fun. That you're kind of working the nose wheel a little bit, the nose.
80 knot climb.
Okay. VY?
Yep. Yep. So up to 1,000, level off, and then we'll head outside.
And I like to use 1,100.
Okay.
I don't know if he's teaching 1,000. I'd like to
okay.
be teaching 1,100.
Just because of the pattern altitude, right?
Well, it keeps you 1,000 feet above the housetops.
Gotcha.
If you think of the sea level around here.
Gotcha.
And, staying above. And our agreement with the tower is 1,100 feet within the Class D. You know, that's just a special local agreement
yeah.
we have here due to the military traffic. So, don't have to do that everywhere. That's coming in and doing their breakouts overhead at 1,600 feet.
Doing a bit to go.
Man, I didn't bring the hood. Darn it.
No.
You want to just take a minute
bag, yeah.
and just kind of go eyes down and quiet on instruments for a moment.
All right, level. Go back to power a little bit.
Good.
A lot of play in that.
Yeah, come back to 2400. So if you have a power setting,
yeah.
always have a power setting in.
little high, cracking. My throttle's a little sticky.
Okay. Now this one, you might be able to loosen it up here if you need to. We're just about to leave the Class D airspace, so you see the dotted green line there. Once we leave Class D, we can climb up, say, under 2,000.
You want to go up to 2,000?
Yeah, just wait just till we get across that line there. But
leave the landing light and fuel pump on, or?
So you can do your cruise checklist.
Yeah.
Got your, does it have it out of 1,000, or it's got a cruise checklist? Climb checklist out of 1,000.
Pressure's good. Engine instruments, and then we'll climb up. Are we outside the Delta?
Yep. Yeah.
All right, here we go with the power.
That little high-rise golf, golfing area down there. I don't know what that's. Go tee off the third floor. See how far you can hit it from there, I guess.
Top golf in there.
Top golf. There you go. Yeah. Have you? Okay.
Yeah. All right.
So, well, we got a few little clouds here. We'll have to stay. How far below these clouds do we have to be?
About 500 feet below.
Okay. It's hard to tell.
No, just stay at 1,500.
I'd say they're about 2,000, so let's go with 1,500 for now. So we can find a spot we can get on top of these. Little things just coming in here in the evening.
All right, level up here. Phillips.
And let's go ahead and turn out this way, maybe some more clearing that way. Turn out to about a south, maybe a 200 heading. Good. It is pretty hazy. I'd be surprised if that's really 10 miles visibility even.
Yeah, it looks about 5 miles.
Yeah. Then you see the solid line is the Class D airspace, so the 2,000 foot shelf there. And when we get right over here, there's a 3,000 foot shelf area. It's in the area, practice area Charlie, we call it.
Okay.
Maybe they'll get past these clouds or something.
Yeah, it looks like the.
Looks better on out that way.
1,800 feet or so.
Yeah.
Come back to.
This is a good area really to do ground reference maneuvers also.
Yeah, we usually go down to that prison.
Okay.
Down by Galveston.
Okay. Yeah, that's a good spot. Anywhere where you have a nice open area, you're not doing it over houses and buildings and things.
So direct to you, I'm just going to dial in Ellington. Right. Okay. Is that right?
Huh? So you want to go up to South Central USA. I don't know, it's got different, or the airport there. That's it. Turn on right again to about 240 and see if we can find a place we can climb up. Otherwise, maybe we'll just do some ground reference maneuvers and then go get some landings.
That's fine. There's that tower.
There's the tower south of Pearland, so, yeah. Yeah, it's been perfectly clear all day.
Yeah, the METARs are showing clear and 10 statute miles of visibility, but I checked the radar, didn't see any moving in.
Stuff as the temperature cools a little bit in the evening now. But yeah, it looks like we can climb up here a little bit now.
past, do you want to get past the clouds first? Or?
Yeah. But we're entering, see, now we're entering in this area that where the Class B goes up to, goes down to 3,000. Yep. So we have a 3,000 foot shelf now. If we can climb up through here, we can climb up to 2,000
and
do,
some, right there,
do
right?
some maneuvers. Yeah.
KLV.
Yeah, KLVG. And you can see it there, just in front of the wing.
Yep. Okay.
Let's go ahead and climb on up to 2,000 now. I think we'll be good there by the time we get clouds a little higher. Our 1,200 foot tower right there, so. So this is Alvin. You know the area out here, just kind of get used to what you're seeing out here, where Pearland is in relation. And then a lot of good practice area out this way also. That's. Have you been using 123.5?
No.
So we'll switch you over to 23.5 practice area radio, so that everybody else will be on that frequency. And I'll just make an announcement here and say we're in Area C over Alvin.
Some birds.
Whoa! Whoa! Eagle? We're over Alvin at 2,000 headed westbound. Practice area Charlie Grumman 1197 Golf over Alvin at 2,000 headed westbound for some practice. Usually then if anybody hears us and they're in the area, they'll respond. And but just here, just as soon as we get past Alvin, we're at 2,000, we can do some maneuvers at this altitude. So let's do a clearing turn.
Okay.
Let's start with a 90 degree turn to the left and then a 90 degree turn back to the right. And we look back that way and look behind us. And
yep, we're clear besides those birds.
Okay, very good. That's funny. You kind of look at your heading here, you can turn back now. So you've turned
about
almost all the way around.
Okay.
Rather than 90 degrees. So.
Yeah, sorry, we always do like 180s. And then,
okay. Well, you could do either way. You could do 180 or 290, but I wanted to continue to go out that way since it's clear out that way.
Gotcha.
So. 290s, that way you're looking to see what's kind of behind us as we get rolled out here and start to do maneuvers. So we could pull out about on a 240 heading and just slow on down and configure.
Okay.
And practice a little slow flight. So I like to slow it down where the stall horn is just kind of chirping on and off. Maintain your altitude using your trim. Just reaching down there and use that trim, it really help you out. Trim's your friend. There you go. And you can put in your flaps in stages.
How far on the flaps do you
want? Well, we'll go to full flaps, but okay. I usually do one third at a time and kind of stabilize, and then another third.
Heartbeat.
Yeah. Good, very good. Okay, so we'll just stay here at 2,000, let it slow on down. Again, use your trim as necessary. We'll get that. Okay, they're getting a little chirp. See if we can stay right at 2,000 while we do this. So it takes kind of the backside of the power curve is that, that phrase
go.
Comes from. There you go.
A little low.
And how's your ball there? A little right rudder maybe?
Yeah. We're never gonna, you want me to put power in and climb back up to 2,000 or you want to hold my?
Yeah, go ahead and climb on up, but go ahead, you've got a little extra airspeed now too, so you can pretty much just pull up and trade that airspeed for altitude. There you go. Right, let's make a shallow right turn to about a 270 heading. Alright, you want to hold, pull your power back again so you'll slow back around 60 or whatever, just getting that horn there. That's all good. Oh wow, we're getting all this static. Oh. Welch pushed. Alright, very good. Again, you'll kind of work on holding that airspeed right at 60. Holding your altitude.
I noticed
right
that at, when I pull the power back, it starts to descend a little bit, but I'm not bringing the nose up.
Yeah, again, you just got to trim and pull. And whatever it takes, you know, just make it happen. So you're doing real well. Good. All right, so now we can transition right into an approach stall.
Okay.
So what we're going to do is just lower the nose and set up just like we're on final approach at 70 knots, probably 1500 RPM. Put pull back to 1500. There you go. All right, we'll descend. We'll play like we're landing at 1,700 feet, and maybe we overflare kind of the scenario. So go ahead and pull back here at 1,700. Pull your power all the way off. You'll remember your stall recovery is full power, flaps to 2/3. Okay, hold 1,700 feet as you pull. Now watch outside and just make sure that nose kind of keeps coming up until we feel a good buffet. Holding the rudder to keep the nose straight. Pulling just a little bit. There's a buffet. Feel that buffet?
Yep.
All right, so recover. There you go. Full power, flaps 1, 2, 3, off. Good. And we'll just recover back, bomb on back up to 2,000. Good. So, good recovery. I like to really teach using the rudder here to keep the nose straight. Do you remember the spin recovery technique?
No, I mean, we talked about it recently, but...
Remember PARE, P-A-R-E.
Okay.
So power to idle, so you don't get, because now you're headed straight down
in
the spin.
Yeah, you want to slow that down.
Aileron's neutral, so don't try to steer it with the aileron. So that's why I kind of bring it up with stalls. If you try to keep the nose straight with rudder rather than aileron while you're practicing stalls. And then rudder, full opposite rudder to recover from the spin.
Okay.
And then push forward on the yoke to recover from the stall. Even though you're headed straight down, you're still stalling because what? You're probably pulling all the way back thinking,
that's
I don't want to go straight
down.
Yeah,
no airspeed.
So people sit there pulling all the way back on the stick, stalling and spinning, and don't think to push forward. All right, at 2,000 feet, let's turn back to the right to north. And a matter of fact, we'll just do a 180 back to about a 060 heading.
Gotcha.
There's those big 2,000 foot towers at Missouri City up here a ways. And let's set up for a departure stall.
Okay.
So we'll go ahead and slow to about 70 level. And then we'll pitch up and add full power or right rudder. I always say full power right rudder is one word. Throw that power in there, particularly the Tiger will really want it left on. And just pitch on up, but sure it's going to be a pretty high pitch up.
How far up do you want to go?
Well, enough where you get a buffet.
A buffet.
Yep. Again, watch these clouds and keep the nose straight. Watch outside with the clouds. Keep them straight with your rudder. I want to feel those feet moving a little bit. There you go. Okay, go ahead and add full power and pitch up. Pitch on up. Way on up here. Gaining airspeed rather than losing. So pitch on, pull on up, pull on up, pull way back. Pull way back. Pulling, keep pulling, keep pulling. Great, very good. Keep pulling. Now don't recover with the ailerons, recover with the rudder when it breaks. If it there's your buffet, so you can just recover from that. And you didn't really need to use rudder because you kept it straight.
Yep.
I don't really feel your feet moving much, but
yeah. Kind of giving it constant brake pressure on that.
Let me take one and just kind of demonstrate one where it does brake, and I'll kind of influence it so it does. This airplane is really stable, so I try not to go in the cloud. Pull back up there enough. Pull way up, and I kick it a little bit. There it starts to brake. Well, even then, it's just kind of going easy.
Yeah.
But see how I'm going to recover you just using the rudder. So that's the point I'm trying to get at on that. Okay, you have the airplane.
Okay.
Let's descend back down to 2,000, and we'll do a steep turn. Kind of uneasy having the nose up that high.
Yeah, no, it doesn't feel really good at all.
Something that you need to kind of learn, because you'll do it on your check ride. You want to get it up high enough where you do get a good buffet.
That way it doesn't make you do it again, right?
Right. Yep. There you go. If you only want to do it once, then do it right. First time.
Pull the power back and then we'll descend down to 2,000.
Yeah. Now we're kind of over a sparsely congested area. Not too bad. There's plenty of emergency spots should we need it.
Yeah.
So this is okay. But what I do is get set up on a cardinal heading, and
there's that tower over there.
Yeah, I'm thinking we can go, let's just turn due. Well, let's just use 60. And you've got your heading bug, so that's kind of a useful thing. We'll start out on a 60 heading. Set about 2,000 RPM, and that's going to give you about 90 knots in the airplane. And you've got, you don't really need no carburetor heat with 2,000.
Yeah,
Spectre, which as warm as it is.
He always tells me to do it with when we're out of the green arc.
Okay.
Like closer to 1,500.
Okay, maintain 1,900 feet, and let's do a steep turn to the left.
Okay.
Take a quick look out that way, clear left. Okay. So add a little bit of power as you roll into your turn. Kind of pitch up here, but really look outside. You see what your outside reference looks like. There you go, and there's
45 degrees.
Right. So this, from where you are, you see that hinge line right on the cowling, right? A little bit steeper now. You're at 30.
How far do you want to go?
Yeah, we're going to go all the way around.
Okay.
So go ahead and hit that 45. Pull back a little bit. You're descending some. There you go. A little bit steeper now. Pitch on 45. There you go. So there's your sight picture right there. All right, as you come around at 30 degrees up prior, I'll call approaching a heading, start to roll out. Roll on out and pull your power back now so you stay at 90 knots. So even as you roll out, you want to stay at 90 knots. Okay, good. Got that sight picture there. And when you go solo, you can go out and do these and just do a whole bunch of them and get really confident about pinning your altitude and things and your airspeed throughout. Let's go ahead and do one to the right. So on the right, you're going to be looking at the top of the cowling will be on the horizon.
Yep.
Okay. There you go, right there. Lose a little altitude. Kind of roll out of your, if you lose altitude, roll out of your bank so you can climb back up some. Just roll to 30 degrees or so. And then you climb and then go right back to the 45 and hold your nose up. And good. That's about right. Approaching a heading.
Yep.
Very good. All right, let's turn right to 150. And blown a little further right, 200 degree heading, turn out this way. So we think about engine failure. Go ahead and climb on up just a little bit, and we'll talk about engine failure.
Okay. Fuel air spark.
Yeah. And so the first thing is, what's the first thing on your checklist? Best glide speed.
Yeah. So we'll trim about for 70 knots.
Trim for 70, I think it says 72. So trim up for 72 and then start looking for a place to land. and we want to land into the wind, right? Yeah. So how do we know where the wind's from?
It was out to the south earlier from the last ATIS that we got.
Still
a little high.
So what direction do we want to land?
We want to go land to the south.
Land that way. Okay,
yeah.
Good. You can look at your heading indicator and
yep.
kind of get an idea. So you can pick a field down there that you can land to the south on.
There's a nice little open field
okay.
right there.
And then while you're doing that, you're going to think about...
Actually, we'll go there.
Whatever, what acronym he gave you for troubleshooting.
Yep.
And while you're doing that, keep in mind maneuvering and make the machine maneuver to that spot.
Okay.
We're gonna go around at 500 feet. I'll give you simulated engine failure.
Okay.
Pitch for 72. Here's your trim. Pick out a field and keep that in mind. Got to kind of think about what it's going to take to get down to it. If you're right over it, you won't be able to land on it. I'll just show you what I do. I go through a flow pattern, start down here, and I switch fuel tanks.
Okay.
The most likely thing is I ran out of fuel on
yep.
one of my tanks. I switch tanks, mixture, check that, throttle.
Fuel pump.
Fuel pump is over here, right? Carburetor heat, so maybe we froze up. And that's about it. Some people switch the mags on and off. That's about all we could do to try to, so it doesn't restart. Now we want to think about forced landing.
Yep.
So we're going to turn everything off. So I start back down here. And I'm going to simulate turning the fuel off down here, Alex.
Yep.
So I'm going to turn the fuel off, mixture off, all my electrics off. I still need my flaps.
Yep.
I still need electrics, so I'll leave the master for now. Go over here and turn 21.5, or I can just push this button and hold it for... I'm doing the wrong thing. I can turn 21.5, make a bay data call, style 7700 in the transponder. All right, how you doing on your field?
We're going right there.
Okay.
More of a south heading, but we'll turn base.
Okay, so that looks pretty good. This green field,
yep.
there's those cattle over there, but that looks like a really nice soft field to land. So see if you can maneuver.
It's kind of marshy down there, but it's pretty dry on that side,
right.
so that's where we're going.
See if you can maneuver.
We'll turn base in a south heading here.
Okay. And
we'll use that as our kind of aim point.
What I see is people turning in too early.
Yep.
Now you have tools to help you get down, right? Full
yep.
flaps
yeah.
and
we can
slips.
Slip it.
Done some good slips.
We're going to maintain 70 knots, and then we're making our base turn right
now. Okay.
And then we'll be, last thing on the checklist was the transponder and then the radios, right?
Right, and then open this canopy
yep.
so it doesn't get jammed shut on us.
We'll do some flaps.
Okay.
Your feet, knock it off.
Okay, very good. And you could come out here and turn and land right into the south and you'd be perfect. So nicely
yep.
done.
So
let's go around.
Here.
Absolutely. Full power, carburetor heat. What's that noise?
What's that?
That beeping noise?
That's a stall horn.
Okay.
Yep,
so don't bring the nose up too high.
Yep.
Good.
Now I got the airspeed
okay.
and we're keeping the calendar.
Nicely
on
done.
There.
Just want to think about while you're doing all that, like I was
yeah.
saying, do the flow pattern, and then if you're up at a good altitude, you'll have time to get your checklist out and go through the checklist also, make sure you got everything. All right, let's turn right to about a 150 right now, and we'll turn in that ASOS when we get a chance.
1,000.
Pearland Regional Airport.
Automated weather observation.
I just want to give us a little more space.
Zulu. Wind 230 at 04. Visibility 10. Sky condition clear.
So wind's 230 at 4.
Celsius.
So conducive for runway 1. Going to be a little bit of a crosswind, but light point on for 14.
Remarks.
Out.
Density altitude 2,000.
It's given the density altitude, which is good
airport.
To know.
Automated weather observation 2203 Zulu. Wind 210 at 05.
Okay, now it's 210 at 5,
zero.
So it updates every 2 minutes, like
sky
I said.
Condition,
I'll tell you what, I have the airplane. Okay.
So,
now you know you're over Alvin, you could probably use your sectional to find your way up to LaPorte or Pearland.
Yeah,
but let's do this. Let me have you show you how to pull that into the GPS if you haven't done that.
Observation.
So select. Let's go ahead and turn that off. In fact, we could go ahead and put 22.8 in there. Okay. And now see that background noise?
Yep.
Okay. Now you got to put that on number two to transmit. Okay. So, I don't know. Let's use this radio. I'm going to just, still have step. Okay, that's a little better. Okay, so push this direct to button. And then you could use the knobs, and I saw you use them, how to change it to KLVJ.
Yeah.
And there's another way to do that. Let me show you, since you know, I think you know how to do that.
Yeah.
Even though you're, so use the little knob to change, and then the big knob to change fields. Little knob always changes values. The big knob changes the field.
Traffic Warrior 5-4 Mike Curley, about 7 miles to the west, inbound 1600, wide.
All right, there it is. So hit enter, and activate. Okay, now it says our desired track is 007. So I'm going to put 007 up here, and we're in VLOC mode rather than GPS mode. Well, we want to be in GPS mode, right, because we're tracking the GPS, not a VOR. So there you have it. You have
some traffic right there in front of us.
Where?
All right, yeah, he's close.
Woo! Cloud right here, too. So expedite down here. It'd be assertive with the airplane. Pull the power back and get on down out of the cloud and that. Yep, gotta keep our eyes outside, huh? Good. So we're navigating now, as long as we keep the needle centered. Have you done that at all? If your needle goes off to the right, we want to pick a heading that's off to the right and fly that until it centers back up. Stay up here, try to stay up here above 1200 anyway, until we see that tower. Okay, so we're navigating up to Pearland. You can kind of...
Tower's right there.
Okay. All right. We have the airplane.
Okay.
We'll stay here at 1500 for now. And what we'll do is we'll cross over the airport and do a teardrop entry back into that downwind leg.
Landing to the south, right?
Landing to the southeast.
Okay.
We're 5 miles from the airport. Can't really see it down in the... No, I do see it. They're just off to the left, actually, a little bit. If we look, we need to turn just a little bit left here now. See kind of a big round white golf ball?
Yep.
That's a radar tower that's on the field there at Pearland. A good thing to look for is hangars, kind of an open space with big buildings around. Looking for an airport. So we'll fly over here at 1500 and we'll turn to the right and we'll basically fly out far enough where we can come back in and make that 45 degree angle. While we're doing that, we'll descend down to pattern altitude of 1,000 feet.
Okay.
And I'm going to make a radio call from here. Pearland traffic. Grumman 1197 Golf is 4 miles south. We're going to fly over and enter a downwind for runway 14 Pearland. How are you doing?
Down traffic at 5-0, upwind runway 14 for Tango, Baytown traffic.
So he's doing 14 at Baytown, so that's sometimes confusing.
Baytown way out there.
Yeah, same runway, same UNICOM frequency. But
yep.
So, very good.
Is somebody taxiing out there?
Somebody taxiing out there, yep, good.
Climbing down, climbed up a little bit.
Okay.
Full power back.
There you go. So you sounded like you actually were doing pretty good on the radio there at Ellington. We turn back here, I'll have
Pearland
you
City.
Pearland Regional.
Okay.
We'll just call it Pearland.
Okay.
Pearland Traffic.
Okay.
You can say Pearland Traffic, 197 Golf overhead. Be a teardrop back for the downwind, 1-4.
So teardrop, downwind, turn right to...
center left downwind.
Okay.
Yep.
So we're going to do a full 180, or do you want to do a right?
Well, you're going to do up almost a 270, really.
Okay, right, 270 into the downwind.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so once you get kind of past the pattern area,
yep,
we can start descending. And we've got to be a little careful. You see Ellington right there.
We don't want to get too close to Ellington.
Let's go ahead and start a right turn. And really, if you come back in and come right over Friendswood High School right there,
it'll
kind of give yourself
point.
Enough space to get coming in over the high school there.
Wider traffic, Warrior 5-1, Mike Charlie, left downrun, 10827, wider traffic.
All right, descend on down to 1,000. And again, give you just a little more space here. And that'll be give us room to kind of see what we're doing when we enter there.
Okay.
But again, right on down to 1,000, so kind of expedite down.
8 down traffic at 5 at Sierra. Left stays runway 14, for the Tango. 8 down traffic.
Fairland traffic, 1197 Golf entering downwind 1,000 feet. Fairland traffic.
So as we come in this way, we've got a good view of anybody climbing on the crosswind, which is real important. Below us, kind of hard to see down below the horizon, but so if we're doing this 45, we can see them down there. And we can see anybody else that's doing whatever they want to do, because they don't always do the right thing. All right, maintain 1,000 feet now. You can let it slow down to about 90.
Traffic, this is 735. Double Echo is ready for takeoff delivery number 4. My destination is Southwest Houston Airport.
Warrior 5-4-9. Again, use your trim whenever you change power settings.
Fairland traffic, 1197 Golf down 114. Fairland traffic.
There you go. So I go to flaps 10 here. Has he been having you do full flap landings? Or
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay.
Set power setting, car beats out 1500.
Full pump landing light.
More set on a
first speed. This is 735 double echo. It's delivered in 14.
And final runway 27 wide.
All right, we'll turn left base here.
Okay.
Fairland traffic, 1197 Golf turning left base, runway 14. I think this guy's getting onto the active.
Yeah, might give him a little more room.
Yeah,
there.
We'll extend out here and then
there you go.
We'll make a final turn.
Very good.
Kind of a dog leg here, but... Alright, he's taking off, we're taking one. Fell in traffic, 1197 Golf left base, 14, fell in traffic.
Hey, down traffic at 580, the upland, runway 14, 4-6-10-go. Hey, down traffic.
70 knot approaches are full.
Yeah, 70, so 80 here on base is good.
Yep.
Go to flaps 20 if you want. 2/3.
Tail in traffic, 1197, go final 14, tail in traffic.
So now you want to slow right on down to 70.
Yep, power's out all the way.
Okay.
Kind of extended out, we're cracking back on the center line.
All right, there's
our check.
All right,
good flaps are set.
About 70.
There's a power, keep us level. Very low. Aim point at the 1,000 foot mark.
Okay.
Hopefully a little before that.
Yeah, you could aim at the numbers if you want. Short runway. That number's right in the windshield until I tell you otherwise, okay?
Airfield's made.
Down, keep those down, nose down. There you go. Now make it clear. Hold it off, hold it off, hold it off, hold it off. A little Alright, Ada Ron.
Stay down traffic at 5H here, left downwind, runway 14, 4-7, go up, stay down traffic.
There you go.
Power's in, flaps are up, carpute's in. And
right,
rotate.
There you go. Good, okay, good landing, yep.
Tailwind traffic, 1197, golf upwind, 14, tailwind traffic. First landing outside of La Porte in Ellington.
Is that right?
In a while. We flew to Beaumont once.
Right. Okay.
400 feet, we'll turn crosswind. Or, no, 700.
700, yeah. 300 below pattern altitude. And that way you're at pattern altitude when you
in
turn
case
downwind.
You need to turn back in.
Well, and again, it helps everybody else see you if you're at pattern altitude.
Gotcha. There's that. Whatever that one.
Yeah. Yep. Yep.
Tailwind traffic 1-7 golf turning crosswind 14 tailwind traffic.
Wider traffic, Warrior 5-4 Mike Charlie, left crosswind, runway 27 Eliza.
So if we come back and we try to make it a soft field landing, and that was a pretty good soft field landing. The only thing you want to do differently is hold the nose off until absolutely can't hold it off anymore. And really, we want to make all our landings
down,
like that. In this airplane, you saw the poster about the bent prop.
Yep.
You know, we've had a real trouble with the bent prop, and that's what happens is people, if you bounce and push forward. To help avoid doing that, we talk about following through on the landing and just keeping the nose off as long as possible. Landing on the main wheels, holding that nose off, and see how long you can keep the nose wheel. You can actually do a touch and go without ever letting the nose wheel hit the ground. And that's pretty fun.
Tailwind traffic, 197 golf, downwind, 14 tailwind traffic. Can't tell if that's our radio or what.
It's easy to, every time I touch that, to hit the squelch, to disable the squelch. That's what's happening. So just push it again. If I push it, see that the receive light comes on because it's receiving the squelch. Receiving the static.
Alright, flaps are set, powers, carpeats on 1500 for 80 knots. Tailwind traffic, 197 golf left is 14, tailwind traffic. Hello, bump and power, maintain 80 knots.
Wider traffic, Warrior 5-4, Mike Charlie, turn left, 27, Eliza.
Not perch late this time, I will return.
Turn. Traffic Grumman 85 here, we'll be departing the area on the upwind, up front of 14 left, so Baytown.
Parallel traffic, 197 golf, final 14, parallel traffic. Like we're a little high, or blades at speed up.
Both left. Give it a little bit of slip, will help you slow down there. Push that right rudder, push it all the way to the floor. Push hard. There you go. So the reason I'm doing that is so that now you can recover and be stabilized longer. So if you can let it slow down to 65 also, you won't have to float as far. There you go. All right, kind of work that power, hold the nose off, hold it off. Keep pulling back. Okay, your power's all the way off, keep pulling back, pulling all the way back, not quite. So you can still hold the nose off.
Gotcha.
So keep holding it off, all the way up there. All right, now go ahead and add power, we'll bring the flaps up.
Flaps are tracking up, carpet 10 power's in.
So you see what I'm getting at on that slow flight.
Yeah,
you want to really exaggerate it.
Okay.
But that's good, and you're kind of saving the nose wheel also by keeping the weight off of it. So good. Just keep it up where you just can see the horizon over it.
I do it. Did you not climb up to 700?
Yeah. Very
right
good.
At the horizon.
And you're pretty darn good set up for a short field landing on that one. All you had to do was stop the throttle there and let it settle in. So why don't we just...
It seemed like our sink rate was a little higher that time too, but I think we're aiming for the numbers at that.
But I think you kept a little power in, which is what you want to do on a short field. On a soft field, we want to chop the power. And just simulate getting on the brakes. So kind of tap the brakes to so that I know you're thinking about the brakes. We won't tear them up like you really would on a no-shit short field landing.
Maryland City traffic, 1197 Golf, crosswind 14, Maryland traffic.
Baytown traffic, 5121, 2 miles west of the field, he's crossing just north, headed east at 800 feet.
That right rudder, look at your ball right there.
Yep.
So, because of all your power there, even though you're turning left, you need a little bit of right rudder. The Tiger has a lot more left turning tendency than the Cheetah due to the 30 horsepower.
Maryland traffic, 1107 Golf, down 114, Maryland traffic.
Alright, so let's see if we can set it down just past the numbers.
Okay.
This time.
So you said 65 knots is what we're aiming for?
Yeah, even 62 I think is in the book. But then you're going to be flaring out over the grass. You just got to make sure you make it to the runway. And you did a good job of that on that last landing. Because, yeah, like I said, you're really set up for a good short field landing also. Just make sure you get to the runway. Then see if we can land it. And don't try to plant it, but let it settle in. And simulate the break.
Baytown traffic, 3746 mics, currently 2,000 inbound from the...
Oh, really high.
2 miles.
Pull the power out all the way.
There you go, very good. Baytown.
Baytown traffic, 5121, just off the north end of the runway. I'll be heading over to RWJ, Baytown.
Pellet traffic, 1197 Golf, left base, 14, Pellet traffic.
Baytown traffic, what's your altitude?
700.
Roger.
And see what I was doing with the slip was to go ahead and get back in the slot, so to speak, as quickly as possible and
50 knots.
And stay stabilized all the way in.
Seems like we're going to be a little far up. Longer final. There's 80 knots.
And Baytown traffic, 3746 Mike, centering a left downwind, 14, south Baytown.
Maryland traffic, 1197 Golf, final 14, touch and go, Maryland traffic.
So let it slow on to 65 now, kind of get yourself set up. I need to trim up, but pitch up just a little bit.
Somebody's coming into the pattern.
There you go. All right, there you go. Hitters. Right there, keep sending right in. Better come on down. Go ahead and pull your power. There you go. Power's off. And tap your brake. Okay, there you go.
Plants
good. So it floated a little bit farther than we want to that time. Might have had a...
I think I just had the power in a little.
Okay, be sure you chop the power all the way off.
Well, no, I had power out right at the right as we crossed. I mean, right before the threshold, probably about 200 to 300 feet or so. But
so I think that would have passed as a short field landing. It was close. So 200 feet is not much to work with.
Yeah. Somebody said they're coming in at 1500. I didn't hear which direction.
And Baytown traffic, 3746 Mike, left base 144, stop Baytown.
That was Baytown.
No, there's a guy at Asbury final and said parallel in traffic.
Alright, well, I'd just make a call that we're turning crosswind and see if he answers.
Entering downwind for 1-4, full stop, parallel.
Hear that?
Yeah, he said downwind, so I don't know if he was entering or...
Parallel traffic, 1197 Golf at crosswind 1-4, parallel traffic. And I don't see this guy, and he said he's...
Delta Air Traffic Cherokee 352, left crosswind, to the left downwind, Dan Jones, 1-7.
We'd be turning downwind now, I don't see this guy.
And Baytown Traffic 3746, Mike Pottle for 1-4, full stop, Baytown.
What do you want to do?
Go ahead and turn, we've got a good eye.
Palin Traffic 1197 Golf, downwind, 1-4, Palin Traffic.
Pearland traffic, Cessna 94 Golf, turning left base for 1-4.
Okay, so he's... Oh, I just caught a glimpse of him. And then
okay, I see him. He's right. So it's two turns that we have to maintain separation from this guy, right? So if he's turning final,
right,
then we have to be on the downwind leg.
Yeah, and if you see him crossing a beam of you, that's about correct. Your spacing will be good.
So we'll just extend till he's off the runway for a final.
Yeah, but as long as he gets past our wing.
Pearland traffic, Cessna 94 Golf, turning final 1-4, Pearland.
That is a full stop, so...
Why is the traffic order 5-4, Mike Charlie, turning left downrun, runway 27, wide.
Checking about, what, 5:30?
Dan Jones, there, traffic Cherokee 352 is on a left downwind for 1-7, Dan Jones.
That guy out there. We'll extend out further.
That's southwest leaving,
yep.
So. Air factor.
Give us a little bit of time to get off the active.
Alright.
Car out. Pellet traffic 1197 Golf. Left base, 1-4 pellet traffic. You want to head on out? After this one?
You know, I was thinking about giving you one engine failure in the pattern. If you want to do one of those, we'll kind of keep it in tight, and I'll give you a simulated engine failure on the next.
There's 80 knots. More second. And that guy's turned off in the active.
Dan Jones, Harry Traffic, Cherokee 352, turning final approach, 1-7, Dan Jones.
Pearland Traffic, Cessna 94.
There you go.
Pearland Traffic, 1197 Golf, final 1-4, Pearland Traffic. Kind of warm today, huh?
Warming up.
70 knots, power's out.
Okay, see if we can slow it down to 65.
Yep.
Keep stabilized, get trimmed and stabilized for 5. There you go. One big tree to the right there.
Yep. You're like riding that snowhorn all the way down in this configuration.
Just
what it feels like.
Not much leeway on the sauce. There you go. Alright, keep those down, drop your power all the way. Little. There you go, perfect. Other than let you get you off your crosswind. Center line a little bit there.
Yeah.
Okay, good. So on a short field takeoff, you're going to climb out at VX. So we might just rotate, keep your right rudder, keep on the center line, pull up and climb out at 70. There you go. Pitch right on up now. Pitch way up. Pitch up. Pitch up. Pitch up. Hold 70. There you go. Let's see what your pitch looks like there for a short field takeoff.
That's where your stalls are probably going to come in, huh?
Well, if you stay at 70, you're fine.
Yeah. And you can overpitch.
Yeah, just know, look outside, look at your pitch, but look at your airspeed also.
Pillow traffic, 1197 Golf, upwind of 14, pillow traffic.
And Jones Area Traffic, Cherokee 352.
You're simulating clearing a 50-foot tree. I kind of simulate a 200-foot tree. If we keep our downwind in tight, and I'll give you an engine failure.
Okay, we'll turn crosswind
beam
down
the
then.
Numbers.
Pillow traffic 1197 Golf. Crosswind 14, pillow traffic. We'll turn in downwind here.
Hydro traffic, Warrior 545, Charlie, turn left crosswind, runway 27 right.
Center altitude, power out.
Dan Jones, Air Traffic, Cherokee 352 is on downwind, left traffic, 17 Jones, that's your go.
Pillow traffic 1197 Golf is downwind 14. Pillow traffic.
Wiser traffic, Warrior 54 Mike Charlie left downwind 1127 Wiser.
Alright, well there that engine just sputtered and died for
okay,
some reason.
Okay, so we'll switch tanks.
Okay, first thing is trim for airspeed.
Yep.
Good. That'll give you a little more.
There we go. Alright, touching everything. That's sure's rich. Put that down.
You don't get too far away now.
Returning
to base. You want to stay high.
Pillow traffic 1197 Golf, left face 14.
You can
and
always.
Touching all that. Fuel pump.
Very good. You can always slip and S turn and flaps and whatever to get down, but if you get too far away, screwed. So stay high.
Yep.
Go ahead and turn it in.
Two, three. Leave the flaps at this setting.
Yeah. You're absolutely sure you got it made.
Maryland traffic 1197 Golf final 14. Oh, we got. We're really high.
Well, just I wouldn't say you're too high. Cause remember, you don't have any power now.
Final approach 17.
So you're not particularly too high.
Go full flaps now.
Got a little extra airspeed. So okay. And you're coming in over this tree. So that works out. That's like a 100-foot tree right there.
Yeah.
There you go. Perfect.
Fairland traffic, both starts at Hotel Kilo, 3 southwest, entering crosswind 14.
It's going to float for a little bit. Probably right up.
Hold that nose off. Get on the center line. Back on the center line. Hold the nose off. Hold it off. Let it turn. Center line, or right rudder. There you go. All right, there. Flaps up.
Flaps are up, carbs in, power,
right rudder, center line. You're always landing to the left.
Yeah,
of the
I don't know.
Everybody
do that.
Does that.
Yeah. I think it's just my endpoint looking up.
When you sit on the left seat, you tend to do that. When you're in the right seat, you tend to land on the right seat. So you got to counteract that for yourself. All right, very good. Good work.
All right, depart out to the south.
Yep. And
we'll pick up ATIS back at the.
We want to think about now. If you zoom out here, come.
Pillow City traffic 1197 Golf is departing to the south.
Just want to be sure we turn out and we stay far enough out of the Class D airspace there. Pick up the ATIS again. Very good.
You have India.
But really, if you stay, there's a blue water tower.
Yep, I see it.
Stay
right
that side of that. Good shape.
Information India 21500, wind 18060,
sky conditions 3500
scattered, temperature
28.21,
altimeter 29 or 72.
Expect dial and approach runway
17 right, advise
initial contact, you have India.
India.
Put in tower.
Ground.
Maintain VFR permission, change approved.
7 up Tango, see you in a few hours.
Alright.
So I've never approached Wellington from the south from here, so do you want to stay at 1,000 feet, outside of the delta?
Yeah, stay, well, you can go up to 15.
Okay.
You just want to be at 1100 when you enter the D airspace again.
Okay, so we call them entering and then downwind.
You can go ahead and kind of head toward that water tower there. But so we're, you know, we're west of the airport, or
yeah.
You could just say we're just off Pearland inbound with
India. Yeah, we always enter in by the channel bridge over there.
Well, go ahead and call him here and head for the water tower. So he's probably going to have you just enter a straight in on the downwind.
Okay.
In this case, since you're from this side. But no, you don't have to go way back into Baytown or Bayport. Let me show you something else real quick.
Yeah, you can.
I go back out of that and I move the cursor down to this field.
Okay.
Right there, and I move the little knob.
It'll get to the nearest one.
I could go Ellington and then direct to, so it saves having to type it in. All right, come on. Didn't work. Why didn't it work? I'll do it here.
There we go.
Activate, then direct to, enter. There we go.
8 miles to the south?
Yep.
I like to tell we're November 1197 Gulf with India, 8 miles south.
Command 1197 Gulf, Ellington Tower, squawk 0457.
0457, 1197 Gulf. So we made two-way, we can proceed inbound.
Correct.
So once he gives us the downwind, when do we get, we transition 1100 to 600 pattern altitude?
Just when we get
into the downwind.
What I think of is I want to be able to glide to the airport.
Okay.
If I have an engine failure.
Okay.
So that's why I stay up here even a little bit higher until I get to the D. I'm always wanting to get as high as I can, really.
Grumman 97 Golf, enter a left downwind. Are you going to be full stop?
And that's affirm, sir, full stop on 197 Golf.
Grumman 97 Golf, enter a right downwind, runway 17 right, and remain outside the Bravo airspace.
Outside the Bravo, right downwind for 17 right, 197 Golf. So we're
okay.
A little non-standard, but we're going to stay on this side.
We're going to stay on that side of I-45, though. So Bravo comes right up to I-45.
Okay, I see it right there.
Yeah.
Wind 1506, clear, touch and go.
You zoom in on this.
Okay. Wind 1197 Golf. Traffic approaching the power plant is a Cessna 172 southwestbound. Altitude indicates 1,600 feet.
And we're looking for the traffic now, 1197 Golf.
Grumman 97 Golf, the traffic will be, call it 2, 3 o'clock, and 2.5 miles.
And we're looking, 1197 Golf.
Roger.
Oh, what power plant are you talking about?
I don't know, 2 to 3 o'clock would put over there, 2 miles.
Yeah.
I think it might be that power, I don't know.
I didn't know there was a power plant out here. There's a power plant way over there on the other side of the, almost at the bay.
About 3 o'clock now, mile and a half, 1,600.
And, yeah, we don't see him, 0970 Golf.
Roger. Oh, we don't
see him?
No, I don't.
Okay.
It's kind of hazy, but yeah, so if you just stay on a normal downwind here, you'll be good on the Class B.
So stay left of those like fuel tank looking things over there.
Might go right over them, you'll be fine. As long as you stay this side of I-45.
Grumman 97 Golf, previous traffic, no factor, they're passing behind you.
And 1-7 Golf, copies.
Oh.
Grumman 97 Golf, report right base.
And we'll report right base 17 right, 1-7 Golf.
All right, very good. Let's again just do a soft field just to kind of practice.
Yeah, it's been a while since I've seen that.
Following,
I'll have to let JD know.
Following that through.
We did that.
Yeah. So now you can descend to 600 as you kind of enter the pattern.
250 mil. Traffic doesn't look so bad when you're flying over it, and then you're stuck in it for 2 hours. Right.
A little slowed down there.
Yeah. Come on down, 100 feet to go.
We'll stay at 600.
Yep.
Go.
Now we're floating at 700 for it, but they had the power in.
Okay. See, they're repainting the old Vomit Comet now. That's good.
Yeah, that looks like they're sending it down.
Really glad to see that taking care of it. They're starting to build that Lone Star Museum also.
Yeah, that would be nice.
Yeah.
I think the tower rate 580 is left down 1417 left. Can we switch 17 right to full stop?
Grumman 858, Sierra, extend downwind. I'll call your base turn. Traffic to Grumman on the right downwind for 17 right, also full stop.
There's 85, get right off the wingtip.
I'll call my base for 17 right, 8580.
All right, here we go, configure 3 seconds.
1197 Golf. Check wheels down, runway 17 right, wind 1505, clear to land.
Clear land, 17 right, 1197 Golf.
Down and welded.
Send out over, and then we'll turn,
Okay.
Base.
This really is a finesse on that when you get slowed and you don't want to let it pop up so much you can't see the runway, but you just want to hold it off the ground.
This is a good base turn here.
Okay, yeah, you're maybe a little tight, so just keep it coming.
Got a lot of runway. It's going to be pretty tight.
Yep, go ahead and turn it on. There you go. There you go, flaps if you want. Or you want to be full flaps for a soft field land. Often, you know, slow, so want to be down at 61 again.
Kind of dogged like that, base turn.
That's fine.
Grumman 858 here, you start your left base, check wheels down. Runway 17 right, wind 1505, clear to land.
Turning left base, 17 right, clear to land, 8580.
Lead off some of the speed. Go kind of fast.
I'll kind of come in with just a little bit of power. Help you out. There you go. Just a little bit. Now kind of bleed it back off and just hold that nose off. Hold it off. Hold it off. Now a little bit of right rudder to straighten the nose out and left aileron. So you need to kind of get like that. Now go ahead and hold that nose off. Pull back. Pull back. Pull back. Pull back.
1197 Golf, turn right, taxiway Bravo. Taxiway
pull back some more even.
And just monitor ground control frequency.
Very good.
And say again for 1197 Golf.
Turn right on Bravo, taxi to parking, monitor ground.
Taxi off Bravo, monitor ground, 1197 Golf. Okay, we're off the active. Clean this up, we'll get past that short. Standby, flaps are up. Leave these off.
After landing, fuel pump off, lights off, yeah.
Not supposed to memorize this, but...
Don't need your nav lights until dark.
Thunder strobe, fuel pump's off, fuel mixture. Heartbeat's off, flaps up. Yep, we're good. Now it's nice to see this flight, different perspectives.
Well, on that landing, you were on the center line, but did you feel like you were kind of crooked?
Yeah.
So in that case,
I didn't put the rudder in.
In that case, you wanted to bring the rudder, bring the nose around, and you'd have to bring the aileron to keep you over the center line. Good. I'm just being picky now.
No, that's fine.
My job.
Grumman 858 Sierra, turn right, taxiway Bravo, taxi to parking, monitor ground.
Round Bravo, taxi to park, monitor ground, 8580.